This week, we have huge news when it comes to the Steam Deck. SteamOS 3.5 is going to be compatible with the Nix Package Manager, and this could be a game changer. Plus, the Deck Verified program hits 10,000 playable and verified games, and a whole lot more. Let's talk about it. Today, it's Steam Deck news time. All right, let's talk about this, because this is huge. You'll soon be able to use the Nix Package Manager on SteamOS, and I can't overstate how enormous this is. Nix packages are highly reliable and they're distro agnostic. In fact, Nix packages are installable not only on Linux distributions, but also on other Unix-like operating systems like macOS. So Nix bills itself as a purely functional package manager, which, for those of you who are not baptized in programming jargon, it's a shorthand way of saying that the software is predictable and comes without unintentional side effects. What this all means is that SteamOS's root file system will remain immutable while still allowing for software packages to be installed. See, some people have found the idea of an immutable file system annoying. I know that a lot of Linux nerds and aficionados do. However, I think that it's key to making the Steam Deck a reliable gaming appliance. So how is this becoming a thing? As SteamOS developer Nefren stated in a support thread on the Nix GitHub, quote, SteamOS 3.5 will have a /nix directory available. Currently, the Nix package is not pre-installed, however. It is currently bind-mounted to the data partition at /home/.steamos/offload/nix, along with other offload directories that are independent of OS updates. This will allow users to quickly set up the Nix package manager, and Linux aficionados will be able to install whatever software they want without having to worry about making the root file system writable. And importantly, this means that you'll be able to install applications that aren't available in the Discover store and have them persist across OS upgrades. I can't wait to test drive Nix on SteamOS, and I'm excited to hear what you guys have to say about this. Sound off in the comments below. And while you're down there, why not like that smash button? It's the best way to tell YouTube that you want to see more videos just like this. You can also check out my second channel, Gardiner Bryant Shorts. There should be a link up here, and if there isn't, it's because I forgot, so make sure you let me know in the comments. I want to thank all of the amazing patrons who make what I do here a reality. It's because of folks like this that I'm able to keep these lights on here. If you believe in the work that I'm doing and want to support this show, you can use the links below and pledge your support. It's all greatly appreciated. Next up, Valve is no slouch when it comes to Linux gaming. They're clearly stalwart in their support and continue to heavily invest, developing not just hardware like the Deck, but also investing in the software to facilitate a superior gaming experience on Linux. Now, Alyssa Rosenzweig, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, reverse engineering lead for the Apple M1 GPU, updated their resume to show that they're now working for Valve, developing upstream graphics drivers to improve Linux gaming. Rosenzweig also worked on reverse engineering the ARM Mali GPU, so they definitely have the experience and qualifications to get this done. All in all, Valve continues to hire open source engineers to build out the free software ecosystem that SteamOS relies on. And unlike Red Hat, they're not trying to hoard free software behind a paywall. So we've talked about this many times before, but seeing as our decimal-centric culture loves nice round multiples of 10, let's talk about a recent milestone. 10,000. That's 10,000 titles on Steam with a rank of playable or verified. Now, according to SteamDB, there are 3,489 verified and 6,579 playable titles as of writing. So in total, there's 10,068 titles that are playable or verified that are part of the Steam Verified program. And that's pretty awesome. That accounts for a little over 1/10 of all of the games on Steam having a playable or verified rank. And if you count the number of games that have been ranked as unsupported, then just over 1/5 of all games on Steam have received some kind of ranking. And while not every game with native Linux support are necessarily playable on Steam Deck for one reason or another, just about 40% of all games on Steam have confirmed SteamOS support. Now, this number will continue to increase as more testing is carried out and the verified and playable rankings continue to grow. Before we move on, I want to talk about some of the excellent merch that we have over at store.heavyelement.io. Now, I've got a few designs here. For example, we've got a wireframe Steam Deck design that I think is pretty smart. And there's also this one that I'm calling Cube Up Your Game. This one is called Find Your Station. This one is called Sinking Green Depth. And we have a bunch more designs. To celebrate Independence Day here in the United States, I'm running a special offer through next Friday. Use the offer 4th of July and get free shipping on your order. Now, merch sales really help support this show, especially with the new YouTube adpocalypse, so merch sales are greatly appreciated here. So have a look at store.heavyelement.io to find your favorite console represented with a little bit of Steam Deck flair. Anyway, that's enough of that. Back to it. So Valve just updated Proton Experimental again. This new build makes a whole slew of changes and makes a bunch of games playable, including Minecraft Legends, Company of Heroes, Battle of Crete, Super Bomberman R, Lord of the Rings Gollum, and Oddworld Stranger's Wrath HD. Plus, there are more fixes for a few regressions. Most notably, there's a fix for Street Fighter VI that resolves network errors between online matches. They've again fixed an issue with EA Desktop, where it sometimes won't launch after an update. And this is yet another example of Proton updates fixing EA Desktop, and it's become sort of a meme, at least here on the channel, sort of like removed Herobrine from Minecraft's updates. You can check out the full changelog below, and if there's a fix for a game you want to play included in this update, go to that game in your library, and then hit this gear icon. Then choose Properties and select the Compatibility tab. Now check this box if it already hasn't been checked, and then choose Proton Experimental from the list. It should automatically download and update everything that you need to, and you should be able to launch the game after that. Finally, let's talk about the beta updates that have hit this week. Last Friday, Valve fixed an error where the wrong screenshots were being displayed for non-Steam games. Then, on Tuesday, there was a small beta client update that addressed several desktop mode issues, including fixes for a few settings not being honored and window control positions. Then, on Thursday, there was a small fix for the notification panel to improve the organization and clarity of notifications. They fixed an issue that could cause an error when entering a valid Steam Guard code, and they fixed a rare achievement animation not showing up when Steam was focused or hovered instead of just pausing. There were several other fixes for desktop mode as well, including an addition of a battery indicator in the desktop overlay and a fix for the URL bar becoming stale. All in all, yet another tremendous week of Steam Deck news and updates. What do you think about any of the stories that we covered in this video? Did we miss anything? Leave me a comment and let me know. I would love to hear your thoughts. I want to give a shout out to my friends on Patreon, my YouTube members, and our ViewSync premium subscribers who make what we do here a reality. If you believe in the work that I'm doing, you can use the links below to pledge your support for this show. That's going to do it for now, though. Thank you so much for spending your time with me here today, and I'll see you guys in the next one.